Hey guys, this is Maya and you are on my channel Bookshot. If you are new on this channel, here I talk all about books, and if you are interested in books, make sure you stay tuned with Bookshot. Today I'm excited for two reasons. Number one, this is my first ever reading vlog on this channel. I have been wanting to make a reading vlog from quite a long time now, and finally today I decided to do it. And secondly, I'm going to read Animal Farm by George Orwell, that too a graphic novel. Just to let you know, this is a book I borrowed from my library. I don't own this book. I have heard a few things about this graphic novel, that this is not a well-adapted version of the original copy, which I have no idea about. I haven't read the original book of Animal Farm. So let's not go with the pre-notions. Let's see how this book looks like. Before I start reading this book, I thought I should Google a few stuffs, because I don't really have an idea. Like, I have an idea, but I don't have a clear idea about what this book is like. So I thought I should Google a few things before I start reading it. So The Animal Farm was published in 1945. This book is like a satirical novella which tells us about the events that led to the Russian Revolution in 1917. This takes me back to my school days, where I used to struggle to remember the dates and events while learning the French Revolution, Russian Revolution and those kind of stuff. Anyways, let's see how the book looks like. Pages are thick. It feels so good to turn these pages. And I'm really grateful that I have a library near my house, because of which I can go through these kind of books. And here we go. The graphics look so beautiful. I think I can finish this book in an hour. Halfway through this book, this story goes something like, there is this man named Johns who has a farm, manor farm, with a lot of animals in it. One day he forgets to close his farm and these animals come out. They conduct a meeting of their own and they decide that it is high time they rebel against humans and take their life in their own hands. This is like, at present, humans are ruling and animals want to take the rule in their hand. And then they have a leader. There is this pig whom they call as Major, and he is the one who is giving them these ideas of freedom. And they call this thought process as animalism. Now coming back to the story, the animalism spreads all over. Animals come together and they fight against humans. Initially they win over humans, and in the meanwhile their major passes away. So the responsibility of this movement is now taken over by two younger pigs whose names are Napoleon and Snowball. So Napoleon and Snowball start making further plans as in how to go about the animal movement and things like that. So they start giving instructions to other animals. As time passes by, it becomes a kind of these two pigs ruling other animals, and then they tend to have their own followership. Some animals follow Napoleon and some animals stand by the Snowball. So basically there is a divide among animals and things seriously start going wrong among them. Just letting you know that there is an animated movie on the Animal Farm. In case if you are interested, do check it out. Just type Animal Farm on YouTube and you will find this 2-hour long movie. I will also leave the link in the description box below.
To the world we all know, which may or may not be the best world possible, once again springtime had come. But all the magic of spring was not enough to conceal the misery of Manor Farm.
So finally I finished reading Animal Farm by George Orwell. This was a 175 pages long, or let's not call it long, a short book. It didn't even take me an hour to finish this book. I had fun reading this graphic novel, and I hope you guys also had fun watching this video. So, Animal Farm is a classic novel, and I would recommend every single person to read this book. I have a Kindle copy with me, which I'm planning to read soon. Do get a copy for yourself. Kindle copy is really, really cheap. Right now it is showing 14 rupees on Amazon. Even the paperback is cheap. It is 80 rupees on Amazon. Graphic novel is definitely not cheap, so I won't recommend it. I am so grateful to my library for providing this graphic novel. I would recommend you to get a paperback or a Kindle copy for yourself. Do read this book. It is a good read. So yeah, that's it for today's video. Do let me know in the comment section, would you like to see these kind of reading blogs in future, or what kind of videos would you like to see on my channel, or anything that you have to say about the video. See you in my next video. Till then, take care, stay safe, bye bye.